A few days ago, I talked about the media's ridiculous, over-the-top reaction to a slightly slowed-down video of Nancy Pelosi that was tweeted out by Rudy Giuliani. One of the false claims by the media was that Trump had actually tweeted out the slowed-down video, when the truth was that Trump had tweeted out a completely different Nancy Pelosi video. The one that Trump tweeted out hadn't been edited at all, and the media tried to conflate the two videos, which I think may have actually been the purpose of the entire feigned outrage. They want people thinking all of these videos showing Nancy Pelosi stroking out are somehow edited or doctored. I pointed out how absurd this reaction from the media was, in part because that they themselves have been caught many times doctoring or editing footage in service of attacking Trump or Republicans. And who better to call out all of these fake accusations other than your friendly neighborhood drone tech? If you enjoy this content and you want to help this channel survive, please consider subscribing to me on Patreon or donating on PayPal. I also accept cryptocurrency, and you can find my public addresses in the description or the pinned comment. One last thing, if you're on Twitter, I would really appreciate it, and it would really help this channel if you could please shoot YouTube a message and ask them to please remonetize my channel. I reapplied months ago, and it seems to be going nowhere. I would greatly appreciate it, and I'll feature all tweets in an upcoming video. Just make sure to include me on the tweet. Thank you very much. Leave it to little Brian Stelter to constantly push the limits of human hypocrisy by promoting and applauding the hunting down of a private U.S. citizen for the high crime of mocking a Democrat.
Let's turn to your scoop this weekend, Noah. This was the one that made her appear to be drunk, slurring her words. This got a lot of attention a week ago, so you all tried to figure out who created it.
Okay, so a quick rundown of this bullshit. This soy bag, Kevin Paulson, actually hunted down an African-American laborer to expose his identity and possibly even incite violence against another Trump supporter. He didn't have to hunt very hard, though, since apparently Facebook just gave up all of his information to the Daily Beast, and all of this over a video that doesn't even violate Facebook's TOS. I'm no lawyer, but that seems really sketchy, and sketchy is exactly how I would describe these fake journalists at the Daily Beast. In a celebratory tweet, the Daily Beast's editor-in-chief said, quote, "He's a relatively rare African-American Trump superfan," implying that he's somehow a race traitor. So not only have they exposed his name and his place of work to the world, but they've now also marked him as a race traitor. Leave it to these regressive left-wing white guys to dictate to black people that they are to monolithically vote for Democrats, or they will be marked a race traitor who will potentially be targeted by the media. Then we have Glenn Greenwald. He's a left-wing journalist who's most known for exposing US and British surveillance programs. He said, quote, "The justifications being offered by rank-closing journalists to justify a major media outlet having investigated, doxxed, and exposed an anonymous day laborer for the crime of posting a mocking video of Nancy Pelosi are almost more repugnant than the journalistic bullying itself." It seems to me that when you have credible, left-wing journalists calling you out, you fucked up. This seems to be just another clear-cut case of a left-wing activist pretending to be a journalist. We know this because Paulson said absolutely nothing about all the major media networks purposely misrepresenting footage of Trump not once, but twice using the same footage in 2 years. Paulson didn't care when all of these same media organizations used doctored footage of the Covington kids, and once again, this footage was used to smear Trump supporters. I don't recall the media ever tracking down or humiliating or doxing the person who originally posted that edited, deceptive video. And in fact, the New York Times still has this deceptively edited video up on their website. It's a proven lie that they continue to perpetuate with edited footage. But no, a private citizen who dares to make fun of Democrat royalty like Nancy Pelosi needs to be taken down.
It doesn't take a Russian bot farm. It's just one person with video editing software tricking people.
And the reason
and the people saying that you shouldn't have named him because he's a private citizen, I'm seeing a lot of people on Twitter saying you all were irresponsible for outing him.
Yeah, I don't think that's accurate.
Oh yeah, guys, it was the Russians again. Everything that happens now is because of the Russians. You see, they're going to use Russians as a rationalization for all their corrupt actions going forward. When Democrats lose an election, it'll be thanks to Russians. When Democrats win an election, the all clear will be given. These people are so out of their damn minds that even this stupid video is treated as if it was a suitcase nuke sent over here by Vlad the Putin himself. It's literally just a video that was slightly slowed down. You can do it with even the most basic free video editing software.
Can you just explain how these videos even work? How it's possible to make these?
Oh my god, I'm a Russian mastermind.
Jimmy Kimmel has been putting out slowed down footage of Trump since 2016. If you Google slowed down Trump, you're gonna find tons of material going back to before 2016. And in fact, doctored footage of politicians is pretty damn common thing to find on the internet. Trump is probably one of the most memed politicians to ever exist. This isn't the first time that CNN and other left-wing propaganda outlets have promoted hate, violence, and doxing against Trump supporters. Remember that hilarious meme that showed Trump choke-slamming a wrestler with a CNN logo over his face? CNN gleefully hunted down the guy who made that and actually blackmailed him for the egregious crime of making fun of CNN. The hashtag CNNBlackmail was actually trending on Twitter at the time, and just take a wild guess who little Brian Stelter blames.
That awkward sentence saying that CNN might in the future reserve the right to reveal the identity, it caused the hashtag CNN blackmail to start trending and about what we saw the alt-right sort of do to criticize CNN for it.
Or how about when CNN hunted down a little old lady and attacked her as being, quote, influenced by Kremlin-linked trolls after she worked with apparent Russian-linked groups to organize pro-Trump rallies. Of course, lying by omission is one of CNN's favorite tactics, and they neglected to report that the same group organized anti-Trump rallies. That little old lady had to move out of her house because CNN had exposed her full address, her name, and she was receiving death threats from those incited by CNN's propaganda. We've seen many, many attacks on Trump supporters in public and even being denied services based on their political beliefs. It's obvious that these people in the media want a target on our backs and they're willing to put us in harm's way in their mission to get Democrats elected in 2020. That's all I got for y'all today. Be careful out there and I'll see you next time.